So now we're gonna jump to the typical 5 point. You can see the top point is above your head. The bottom point on the grid is below your feet. On the left side, you're going from north to east to south. This is just like a fisheye lens would give you in a camera. That's where you get to with 5 point perspective. The one on the left became kind of a little game that I played with. And the one in the middle is looking down at a floor, having the vanishing point be down, that's the main focus, instead of out. And then the one on the right shows a typical breakdown of a complicated rooms around you.
This is an example of 5 point perspective. 5 point is interesting in that there's five different vanishing points, one in the center and four around the outside of the circle. It makes effects like a fisheye lens would give you on your camera. And it also has two sets of lines of the cubes that go to two different vanishing points. So in other words, they're curved line perspective. The only line that's actually a straight line, it's the one that goes to the center point. All of those lines are really straight. So this is the end result of it, and I want to show you how we get to that end result from the very beginning. This shows the grid. Two sets of lines that are curved lines, and then the one set of lines that goes toward that center vanishing point. I usually like to start my drawings with drawing the vanishing points on, and then enclosing it with a circle, so you know that anything outside that circle is actually in distortion land, you might say. This is very similar to two-point perspective in a lot of ways. That whenever you're using the horizontal lines and you're in between two of the points, those are the 2 points that you project to. You can see that I started with cubical patterns. I like to do that just to add interesting cubes to deal with. And then I projected in reverse and got to inside the cube, which is like being inside of a room. The room itself, after once you have those little cubical patterns drawn there, you have to kind of work around them, and it forces you to be a little bit more creative. You can see a lot of this, how I'm breaking into the different walls. These have to be projecting toward the proper vanishing points. You know, so whenever you're on a certain plane and you open up windows or doors or holes in that plane, you have to be projecting toward the same vanishing points that the plane is going to. You can see like the tile on the floor, on the ceiling here, and how it actually fits perfect with the grid. So what you're getting spherically is like a 180 degree picture. Everything, if you could put a sphere on your head, you'd be getting a half of a sphere of view when you do a 5 point perspective like this. I'm also once again using color coding to help keep myself know where I'm at, but also so you can see where you're located. But the different planes are all the same color. Now I'd come back into this with a whiteout and get rid of some of the transparent lines too. I do that at the end. So working out the different planes in this, and you can see now the curved lines are going from the outside points are the ones that are making the curved lines, going from the top to the bottom, a gradual progression that goes in a straight line in the center, but then makes a progression of curved lines till it gets to the outside circle shape. So it actually is working its way in a progressive form toward the perfect circle on the outside edge. The tiles show that very well, as you see the lines, horizontal lines on that ceiling tile. they gradually get more and more curved as they go outward. And that gives you that fisheye effect. But it's the only way you can really gather in this much information is to do a curved line perspective. Once again, I'm adding some different, like, people wandering around in this to help with scale. I mean, if I were to draw these people really, really large, all of a sudden the building becomes small. If you make the people really small, the building becomes large. So you can really control the size of what you're looking at. Some of these cubes I drew at the beginning, so you had to make a kind of little chairs out of them and stuff like that. So it's kind of fun to challenge yourself a little bit. The different colors and the tile there to accent them a little bit. 5-point perspective, you have to really think about your subject matter again and try and think, well, what would really fit with this? When I really want to see a 180-degree picture, what is it I would use for the perspective system? I appreciate you watching and seeing this from beginning to end.